table. All set up. So just going to tie some bags up and stuff. See what happens. And got it about 11 o'clock. Had a walk around. Saw a little bit of evidence of fish movement and stuff, so I thought, right, that'll do me. I'm not in me preferred peg, but there you go. So we're here for 3 nights. See what happens. I'm not going to bait heavy. We're forecast snow and sleet and all the rest of it. So we'll just leave it as it is for now, and just put out 3 solid bags. I'll see what happens. This is where I am. So we'll see what happens, and I'll catch up with you later on. Cheers. Good afternoon. Welcome to my new look vlog, my carp diary. I've deleted all the old content and started again. So, back on my club waters. 3 small pools. Very, very hard. I have been flitting between these 3 and another one just up the road. I had my personal best out of there a couple of weeks ago. At 30 plus. So yeah, dead chuffed with that. But a bit about me, I suppose. I started fishing when I was 12, 13. The normal thing with the old chap. He was a very accomplished angler. Knew what he was doing back in the day when carp fishing was new, really. And I just progressed from fishing a gravel pit with him. Obviously started fishing gravel pits on me Todd as I got older, and then the lure of the bigger waters, the harder circuit waters. Yateley, I've been on Yateley for a little while before. And now I'm on a Christchurch ticket. So I tie all my own rigs, roll my own bait, but I do buy my base mix already done, so I just add the eggs and the flavouring. But I'm going to get into making hook baits. That's what I'm going to be doing. And also, I'm going to be sourcing materials to do bait and spin, which will also be for sale in the new year. I've got to knock up a prototype first and see what goes on. And that's basically it, really. Lived down in Christchurch with my better half. I call women, she thinks I'm nuts fishing in -3, but you got to be here to catch. So that's, you know, that's me. I'll do a few day tickets next year. I've got a good friend of mine from Wales coming down, Mr. Savage. He's coming down here for a session, and then I'm going to go up his way for a session when all the restrictions and that are lifted. But yeah, I've made some really good friends down here. Wayne and Brian are the 2 people I've fished with most. But yeah, it's enjoyable, it's good. I enjoy me fishing. After my antics with, shall we say, the surgeons at Bournemouth Hospital, 2 in 6 months, I unfortunately don't work. I've had part of my stomach taken out and all the rest of it, but I'm not sitting here justifying myself to anybody. I would dearly love to go back to work, but with all the rest of it, you know, there's just no way I can get, I can go back to work. So I find my solace in fishing and spending time with my missus. So that's it really, spending time with the missus and the cats, and looking after the garden and the house and stuff. So that's it, fishing is my therapy. Yeah, I gave it up for a little while, but I've gone full circle and back to it again. Got into me filming and me photography and that again, and so I've put it all together really, and that's a bit about me. And enjoy. You'll see some stills of some tackle and that. I've signed up as a small promo team for a small tackle company, Snag Tackle down on the south coast there. Very small range at the moment, good quality gear, without the carp tax, and yeah, things are looking good. They got some stuff coming out soon. Obviously with restrictions and trade deals and all this sort of stuff, stuff's going to be a little bit longer, but it's not going to have a normal carp tax, so they can keep the prices down, and that's it really. So have a look at Snag Tackle and see what you think. Have a look and yeah, go from there really. So that's it. I'll put a few more bits and pieces together, add on to the end of this, some new titles and that, and then see where we go. So I'll catch you soon. Cheers. Well, good afternoon. It is day 3. I've not done much filming because the cold is killing all my batteries. So, not a lot to report. I've literally just seen one squirrel, so they're moving about on the mooch. Hopefully they'll get on the munch. But, it's been quite quiet. There's another two lads over the other side. They've not had nothing. The lad before them was over the same peg, had a bream, but I'm on the carp front, it's been very, very, very light, yeah, I've got back into me filming and stuff. I'm now a promo team member of Snag Tackle, relatively new company. Started 2020, three friends got together, started doing it. It's not a massive range at the moment, but what they do is good stuff. They do the normal stuff like 360 swivels, fake corn, stuff like that. Just terminal tackle at the moment. We have got some new stuff coming in, can't tell you about it yet, but yeah, the stuff's looking good. It's cheap, but it's cheap quality. I know people are going to see this and think, oof, the quality's not there if it's going to be cheap, but they don't have the carp tax. So the shrink tubing is probably the best I've used. So yeah, have a look. I'll put some slides together on there. A price list of what they do and stuff. It's local on the south coast, so yeah, it's good. Good things, good bunch of fellas. Yeah, they're okay. I signed up for them on Boxing Day, so new to me, but we'll see what happens. But yeah. As I say, it's only a small range at the moment. The range will be getting bigger. And that's it, really. They don't want to make millions out of it, but they just want to subsidise their fishing, which is fair play. Anybody that has a go, it's a massive, massive market. So, yeah, have a look and see what you think. Haven't put an order in yet for the whole range, but I will be getting the whole range soon. Obviously with Christmas, New Year shutdown, so we're looking good for 2021. Just hope all this other business is sorted out soon. I know the country's in a bit of a mess, but you got to keep going. Unfortunately, we're not all going to make it, but we got to stay safe and do what we're told, I suppose. But yeah, Snag Tackle, have a look, and it's looking good. Cheers for now, I'll speak to you soon. Well, morning people. Last day, pulling off very soon. As you can see, it's rather cold. Woke up this morning, our pillow was froze to the old bivy, and that it's all soaking inside, condensation and everything. On the fishing front, nothing. So yeah, it's been all right. I've enjoyed it. Just very cold all of a sudden, so I think they just shut up shop, but who knows, fish are wild animals, so you're on the hunt for a wild animal, so you don't know really. But you know, it's not been too bad. I've seen a couple of shows this morning, but I think it could be tench, so I'm not holding out much hope. I've done one trip back to the car already with a load of gear, so I've only got bivy and hold all to put and my bed share on my barra, and that's it. And that'd be a matter of sorting all the rubbish out, trying to get everything dry. Everything is wet, so it's pretty ropey. So we'll see what happens in the next sort of 20 minutes. I'll sit here for 20 minutes, gather me bits, get me bits up together, and yeah, knock it on the head. And that will be my last trip of 2020. And I'll see you all in the new year. Stay safe and stay well, and all the best. Cheers.